for joining me for your February readings, guys. January was a doozy and it lasted like forever. And I know a lot of people had a lot of emotions and they feel a little heavy and there's consternation. You're not alone. But February, guys, is going to lighten a bit and we're going to be definitely much more action oriented. Please be sure to check your sun, your moon, and your ascendant sign to really get a full picture of the whole month of February. They all correlate to different aspects of yourself, your emotional body, your physical body, your surroundings, how you're going to be perceived and projected. So make sure you look at all three. So let's get started. I'm jumping between decks depending on the signs just to switch it up. So we're just seeing what February 2019 holds for the energy of Taurus, what it's going to bring and how we can best utilize this energy. Okay, let's get started. Those are not for you. There we go. I'm pulling four cards of these readings just to get a better understanding. It's a long last January, so I want to get a better support for February. Oh, it wants to have a clarity card here. Okay. So we have the Knight of Earth, the Eight of Air, the Six of Water, and the King of Air. Now, a fifth card popped up. I didn't mean to, but I'm going to listen to what they say. And it's the Strength card. We just had that for Aries too. Okay, so let's get moving here, guys. February, Taurus, this is a month of really action-oriented. Like I said, the month of February in general is definitely much more action-oriented for everyone across the board, but in different ways and in different areas. For you, Taurus, it's really time for you to buckle down, get focused, and get moving because your mind, whatever it is that you were dealing with in January, the emotions, the thoughts, the lack of confidence that you're feeling, the uncertainty, it caused you to feel trapped. But these things, it's an illusion. It's a mental illusion of being trapped. When you didn't take action or you didn't know which direction to go or what to do, or maybe you're paused, like, I'm not sure how I feel yet, because you're unsure of yourself, you lacked faith in yourself, or maybe even in your decisions, or that you can do something about it. Sometimes with this, especially with the Six of Water, we romanticize things. We romanticize how things have been, should have been, could have been, blah, blah, blah. And then we compare those romanticized thoughts with where we're at. Well, the good old days, or it was easy for them. Why isn't it like that for me? Number one, guys, don't compare, Taurus, don't compare yourself to anybody, including your past self, anybody else's achievements or their relationships or their money or their career, whatever it is. No comparisons in the month of February. It's buckling down and focusing on you. Now, you have the King of Air with the Eight of Air. They're like letting you know you have the confidence. You need to speak with confidence. You need to really balance the mental and emotional energies this month because the Strength card was the clarity card for the King of Air. Guys, you need to stop criticizing yourself. No harsh judgments, no comparisons. You need to forgive whatever emotional things you were going through in January, changes, choices, whatever it is. Love yourself through it. And it's okay. Forgive. Let go. And it sucks. When things don't unfold how we wanted them to unfold or how we thought or we attached our dreams. I worked so hard. You know, relationships are the best example, right? You're with somebody forever. So you imagine this whole life and all of a sudden things go south. Or you went to school for this subject and now like you can't find a job and you don't even want to do it anymore. Whatever it is, guys, you got to stop thinking of how you thought things would be, should have been, could have been, all that should have, could have, would have. Stop shitting all over yourself. Let it go because it's keeping you stuck. Your mental body is keeping you stuck. And there really is a need for you to focus on you and get use that awesome stubborn energy Tauruses can have and just be like, hell no, I'm going to do this. I'm going to focus on myself. I'm going to get things done. I'm going to honor my commitments to myself and to others. And guys, when you have the Knight of Earth too, you have a guardian angel with you. And then guardian angels, we all have them. And then this could be a very physical angel. This can be someone who's mentoring you, supporting you, giving you advice, encouragement, and really being there for you, or even your spiritual posse, the people on the other side. They're really loving you through this, guys. There really is a need for you to stand in your power, to speak with confidence, to be balanced, to be objective and diplomatic. Compromise here. Like, okay, this didn't turn out fine. What can I change? This very much reminds me of the Serenity Prayer. You know, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Stop gnawing on what you can't change and focus on what you can, because it's not the end of the road. It's not the end of the story by any means. You guys are moving forward, especially when it comes to finances, your security, your material world, your home, school, loans, whatever it is. You guys are creating this amazing foundation for yourself. But I feel like a lot of people in 2019, and we've seen it a lot since January, and it's only been 1 month, although it felt like 5 years, that we are not just moving forward and we're not just making great leaps and bounds, we're doing it on our own. Doesn't mean we don't have support, doesn't mean we don't have love and friends, but we're doing it with us, with our approval, with our own encouragement, our own cheerleaders. We're doing it for ourselves, with ourselves, on our own 2 feet. And you're no less than this, Taurus. You really, if you need any help this month, Taurus, maybe seek out, talk to anybody, professional advice, whether it's a mentor, a teacher, a counselor, even a therapist, a life coach. You just need someone to help support you to get your thoughts, structure, foundation, ideas, and plans in order. And you have the tenacity and the hard work and the skill. You have all of that. You just need to have the clarity of vision, the confidence, and like the game plan, and bam, you're at it. Bam, 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 knocking things out and moving forward. You are not trapped. You are not stuck. It's just your mind. You have this. Break free of the illusion of fear that you don't got it. Rejections, not worthy, not enough, none of that bull. You are worthy. You are enough. And we have to tell that to ourselves each and every day, sometimes 100 times a day, 101. Do what you got to do. Put up affirmations around, put up pictures of people that inspire you. Put on, get a playlist that inspires you, makes you feel pumped. Like, I got this. I can do this. You can do this. You got this, Taurus. You're moving forward. You're making waves. You're making changes. And you're moving on, not just forward, you're moving on up, because you're doing it. You're pulling yourself up. Okay? Inner strength, guys. We can do this. Come on, February. Be nicer than January. It's going to be wonderful. If anybody would like a more personalized reading, please feel free to reach out to me at healingwithangelic.com. If you guys have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. And I'll see you for your mid-month readings, guys. Take care.